us, O Lord our God, and gather us from the nations, to give thanks to your holy name, and make it our glory to praise you.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. We hope we have rectified the sound issue. If it's not, please call the office or write something. You know, the soundboard is 20 years old, and one of the channels failed. When we get old, we have hip replacements and knee replacements, and maybe it's time to replace that 20-year-old board. But what does never become old, we should never in our hearts or souls, and that is the celebration of this sacred Mass. We are made present to the eternal banquet. And so it is a ritual, yes, but it is also a living ritual of our relationship with our good God, who the incarnate Son offered his life for the expiation of our sins, more significant than a burning bush or even the challenges between Cain and Abel, because God offered his life for us, and so we offer our praise and are made present to that eternal banquet in heaven. And we seek that eternal banquet because it's a banquet of mercy. It's a banquet of forgiveness. It's a banquet of calling us into the fold of holiness. And so we ask the Lord of mercy to heal us in our brokenness, whether it be a mixer board or a hip or anything else. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. And so we pray. Grant us, Lord our God, that we may honor you with all our mind and love everyone in truth of heart. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the letter to the Hebrews. Brothers and sisters, you have not approached that which could be touched, and a blazing fire, in glooming darkness, and storm, and a trumpet blast, and a voice speaking words, such that those who heard begged that no message be further addressed to them. Indeed, so fearful was the spectacle that Moses said, I am terrified and trembling. No, you have approached Mount Zion, in the city of the living God, the heavenly Jerusalem, and countless angels in festal gathering, and the assembly of the firstborn enrolled in heaven, and God, the judge of all, and the spirits of the just made perfect, and Jesus, the mediator of a new covenant, and the sprinkled blood that speaks more eloquently than that of Abel. The word of the Lord. O God, we ponder your mercy within your temple. O God, we ponder your mercy within your temple. Great is the Lord and holy to be praised in the city of our God. His holy mountain, fairest of heights, is the joy of all the earth. O God, we ponder your mercy. Mount Zion, the recesses of the north, the city of the great king. God is with her castles. Renowned is he as a stronghold. O God, we ponder your mercy within your temple. As we had heard, so we have seen, in the city of the Lord of hosts, in the city of our God, God makes it firm forever. O God, we ponder your mercy within your temple. O God, we ponder your mercy within your temple. As your name, O God, so also your praise reaches to the ends of the earth. Of justice, your right hand is full. O God, we ponder your mercy within your temple. Alleluia, alleluia. The kingdom of God is at hand. Repent and believe in the gospel. Alleluia, alleluia.
Sisters and brothers, the Lord be with you. A reading from our Holy Gospel according to Mark. Jesus summoned the 12 and began to send them out two by two, and gave them authority over unclean spirits. He instructed them to take nothing for the journey but a walking stick, no food, no sack, no money in their belts. They were, however, to wear sandals, but not a second tunic. And he said to them, "Wherever you enter a house, stay there until you leave from there. Whatever place does not welcome you or listen to you, leave there and shake the dust off your feet in testimony against them." So they went off and preached repentance. And the 12 drove out many demons, and they anointed with oil many who were sick and cured them. The Gospel of the Lord. So I apologize again. I don't know if you can hear us or not. I got a text at the beginning of Mass that there was no sound, even though we had sound yesterday afternoon. Well, disappointing, yes. I don't know about you, but I just find the richness of meditating on the scriptures, especially a day before or early morning, and trying to see what is happening there. You know, in that first reading from Hebrews, we have this image. It says, you have not approached that which could be touched and a blazing fire. That's a reference to Moses and the burning bush, or the glooming darkness, or a trumpet blast, Jericho. The tying in between the Old Testament and New Testament is extraordinary. But when I look at it and read it and meditate on it, I also think of the extraordinary, not only corollary, but difference between the two testaments. Because Hebrews goes on to say that the spirits of the just made perfect, and Jesus, the mediator of the new covenant, and the sprinkled blood speaks more eloquently than that of Abel. Remember the story of Cain and Abel? Cain killed his brother Abel. Yes. And then there was a war, there was misery, there was revenge sought among the peoples. But with Jesus hanging on the cross and dying for us, there is no revenge. It is mercy, it is forgiveness, it is calling us into a new covenant and relationship with God. It is the forgiveness. So I have to examine myself and say, are there times when I hold grudges? Oh, indeed there are. And then I'm acting a little bit like the Cain and Abel story. So perhaps today, and even during this Lent as we prepare to fast, we can fast from those prejudices, from those hates, from those disappointments in life that disturb us so much. Because God is mercy and love. God, O God, we ponder your mercy within your temple. Amen. So my brothers and sisters, as we approach our Heavenly Father, we do so in confidence that He will hear our prayers.
For all missionaries sent out to preach the gospel, may God be their leader and their guide. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For world leaders, may God bless their work to bring peace and justice to their nations. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For people who are terminally or chronically ill, may God grant them peace and healing. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For this community of worship, may God bless the efforts of those who teach the faith to others. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died, may they find their eternal home in the city of the living God. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for any special intentions that we hold now in the silence of our hearts. Pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. And we pray for the Martinez family and Gabriel, a wonderful musician and good-spirited man who served us so many years here at the mission. We pray for my brother-in-law, Jeff Potowski, and we also pray for our sisters and brothers in our sister mission in Loreto, for Nuestra Señora de Loreto de Conchol parishioners. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Loving God, we approach you with confidence, knowing that you hear our prayers and always desire what is best for us. We pray in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received this bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it'll become for us the bread of life. Blessed be God forever. With humble spirit and contrite heart, by the mystery of this water and wine, may we come to share in the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received this wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it'll become our spiritual drink. Blessed be God. With humble spirit and contrite heart, may it be accepted by you, O Lord, and may our sacrifice in your sight this day be pleasing to you, Lord God. Lord, wash away my iniquity and cleanse me from my sins. Pray, my sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Father Almighty. O Lord, we bring to your altar these offerings of our service. Be pleased to receive them, we pray, and transform them into the sacrament of our redemption through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in goodness you created man, and when he was justly condemned, in mercy you redeemed him through Christ our Lord. Through him the angels praise your majesty. Dominions adore and powers tremble before you. Heaven and the virtues of heaven and the blessed seraphim worship together with exaltation. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in humble praise as we acclaim, Sanctus, Sanctus, Sanctus Dominus Deus Sabaoth, plene sunt caelia terra, gloria tua, hosanna in excelsis, benedictus, qui venit in nomine Domini, hosanna in excelsis. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that it may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Jose, our Archbishop, Robert, our Auxiliary Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, and our blessed patrons, Buenaventura, Junipero Serra, Cadre Tecahuetha, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him, with him, in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Amen.
Mis hermanos, fiel a su recomendación del Salvador, y seguiremos en divina enseñanza, nos atrevemos a decir, Padre nuestro, que estás en el cielo, santificado sea tu nombre, venga a nosotros tu reino, hágase tu voluntad en la tierra como en el cielo. Danos hoy nuestro pan de cada día. Perdona nuestras ofensas, como también nosotros perdonamos que no nos ofenden. nonos deus caer in tentacion, y libramos del mal. Líbranos de todos los males, Señor, y concédenos la paz en nuestros días, para que, ayudados por tu misericordia, vivamos siempre libres de pecado y protegidos de turbación, mientras esperamos la gloriosa venida de nuestro Salvador, Jesucristo. Reino, quiero poderle con la gloria por siempre, Señor. Señor Jesucristo, que dijiste a tus apóstoles, la paz os dejo, mi paz os doy. No tengas en cuenta vuestros pecados, sino la fe de tu iglesia, conforme a tu palabra, concede la paz, la unidad, tú que vives y reinas por los siglos de los siglos. La paz del Señor esté siempre con nosotros. Dense fraternalmente la paz de Cristo. Cordero de Dios que quitas el pecado del mundo, ten piedad de nosotros, ten piedad de nosotros. Cordero de Dios que quitas el pecado del mundo, ten piedad de nosotros, ten piedad de nosotros. Cordero de Dios que quitas el pecado del mundo, danos la paz, danos la paz, danos. Este es el Cordero de Dios que quita el pecado del mundo. Dichosos los invitados a la cena del Señor.
Your face shine on your servant. Save me in your merciful love. O Lord, let me never be put to shame, for I call on you.
Let us pray. Nourished by these redeeming gifts, we pray, O Lord, that through this help to eternal salvation, true faith may ever increase through Christ our Lord. It is a humble, contrite heart that the Lord desires from each of us. May this day and always we humble ourselves in the sight of the Lord and give thanks for his great mercy. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Holy God, we praise thy name. Lord of all, we bow before thee.